For 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And thank you very much. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to a brand new game of Granite State Challenge. We're still in round number one. Two new teams ready to go at each other tonight. The winner to advance into our upcoming second round. Before we do start our game, though, let's just take a moment and remind you that you can visit our website where you can find details on how you can register as an alum from our program, as well as how to view and download each of the programs from last season and this season. You can do that on both YouTube and through the iTunes Music Store. All right, with that out of the way, let's introduce you to the two teams playing in tonight's game. First of all, we have the team from Laconia Christian School, enrolling about some 50 students located in New Hampshire's Belknap County.
Hello, my name is Matthew Farah, and I'm a senior.
Hello, my name is Mark Farah, and I'm a junior.
Hello, I'm Ethan Goddard, and I'm a junior.
Hello, I'm Alec Duba, and I'm a sophomore.
With us for the program, the coaches for the team, Susan and Scott Farah, and their alternate tonight is Stephen Samuels. They are the Crusaders of Laconia Christian School. So that is the team from Laconia Christian. Now let's introduce you to their opponent for today's game. The team from Stratford High School, enrolling about 62 students, located in New Hampshire's Coos County.
Hi, I'm Megan Hakey, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Amelia Teberge, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Caleb Mason, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Nicole Lachu, and I'm a junior.
Also with us for the program, the coach for the team is Marie Hughes, and her alternate is Chelsea Bishop, the Lions of Stratford High School. Our last introduction is to let you know who our judges will be. And this week, we say hello to Jim McShane and Mary Riley Potter, and thank them for their help throughout the season. All right, in case you're joining us for the first time, we can tell you we play in four rounds. First and fourth rounds are called 10-point toss-ups. Then we have a bonus in a 60-second round, but this is indeed a 10-point toss-up round. Laconia Christian and Stratford, good luck, and here we go. Which organization took credit in 2002 for President Bush's election and then announced it was taking aim at unseating gun control advocates in Congress and defeating campaign finance reform in court? This group was led by Charlton Heston. Alec of Laconia Christian.
The NRA.
The NRA, or the National Rifle Association, is correct. Which Yiddish word, beginning with the letter K, designates someone who is clumsy or awkward? Caleb of Stratford.
Klutz.
A klutz is right for your 10 points. Tens of thousands of people in northern China and eastern Siberia watched the sun totally disappear in 1997 behind the moon for more than 2 minutes. Give the two words that complete the three-word term, Mark of Laconia Christian.
Solar eclipse.
Solar eclipse is right. The three-word term was total, blank, blank. Solar eclipse is right. Good anticipation, and here we go for 10 points. If you think you need the paper and pencil in front of you, you can use it, but listen carefully. What is the perimeter of a square whose area is 25 square inches? Mark of Laconia Christian.
20.
20 inches is correct. Now for 10 points, we want you to name the politician and the spiritual leader who, after practicing law in South Africa, returned to India in 1915 to become a proponent of passive resistance to British rule. Alec of Laconia Christian.
Gandhi.
Gandhi, Mohandas Gandhi is correct. Besides the bassoon and the oboe, which two other woodwinds are basic instruments in an orchestra? Matthew of Laconia Christian.
The flute and the piccolo.
Good try, Stratford. Amelia.
The flute and the clarinet.
Flute and the clarinet is what we were looking for. Now what we want you to do is give the pen name used by Charles Ludwig Dodson, who coined such words as slithy in his poem Jabberwocky. Ethan of Laconia Christian.
Shel Silverstein.
Stratford. hockey was written by Lewis Carroll. With which type of plants was Austrian biologist and monk Gregor Mendel experimenting when he discovered Caleb of Stratford?
Pea plants,
when he discovered the laws of heredity. Well done. Once again, paper and pencil in front of you for this question. Listen carefully now. A basketball player whose five-game performance includes 6 3-point goals, 12 two-point goals, and 18 free throws has compiled what per-game average? And we'll give you a little time to work on that. We've got a five-game performance. This basketball player had 6 3-point baskets, 12 two-point baskets, and he also made 18 free throws. Mark of Laconia 60. Christian? 60. Stratford, Caleb?
12.
12 points per game. The 60 was total. The per-game average was 12. All right, here we go for 10 points. The Barbary States were countries along the coast of Africa. They were taken over largely by what country in the 19th century? Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Spain.
Stratford. It was France. Now we want you to give the nationality that precedes all of the following words. Dressing, Orthodox Church, Revolution, Roulette, Caleb of Stratford.
Greek.
Laconia Christian, Ethan.
Russian.
Russian is right for the 10 points. Still in round number one, here we go with a 10-pointer. Spell the noun tenet, meaning a statement of belief. A mark of Laconia Christian.
T-E-N-A-N-T.
Stratford. Megan.
T-E-N-N-A-N-T.
It is simply T-E-N-E-T, T-E-N-E-T. Which igneous rock, whose name is derived from the Latin for a dark Ethiopian marble, is commonly used to make building stone and road stone? Mark of Laconia Christian.
Marble.
Stratford. It is basalt. Who was the first president of the United States to wear contact lenses? A little bit of trivia. The first president of the United States to wear contact lenses, Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Franklin D. Roosevelt.
Stratford. A little bit later on, it was Lyndon Johnson. What field or discipline, sometimes called the mother of the arts, did German philosopher Friedrich von Schelling call frozen music? Ionic and Doric are terms used in this field. Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Scales.
Stratford. It is architecture. All right, we have about one minute to go in our game. The fourth edition of the New World Dictionary, which has 7,400 new entries, has substituted the usage label informal. Which earlier label begins with C and means conversational? Matthew of Laconia Christian. Stratford. Caleb?
Casual.
The word we were looking for was colloquial. There's the sound ending our first round. We've got a nice score going here right now with Laconia Christian holding on to a little bit of a lead by a score of 50-40. All right, we're going to take our first time out. Tim Estilos rejoins us this week and prior to the program met up with the team members for tonight's game. First of all, he met up with the team from Laconia Christian. Let's listen in.
Hey, Jim, I'm here with a group from Laconia Christian School. Are you guys ready to play?
Yeah!
And Matthew here is the team captain, who's a shy, unassuming kind of guy.
Hardly.
Now, you ride the unicycle. It takes a lot of balance to do that kind of thing.
Well, I'm not very good at balancing, and I can sort of do it.
Now, you also scuba dive. That must have been pretty cool getting your license.
Oh, yes. Well, when we were in Jamaica, we were on, like, this vacation, so we went and got our scuba license. It was really fun. We saw lots of fish and the ocean, sand, you know, that sort of thing.
And you treated the fish very well, I'm sure. Now, over here we have Mark. Mark, you also went to this trip to Africa. So whereabouts was it, and what did you do?
We went to Ghana, Africa, right near the capital, Accra. And we held a 3-night crusade there. And over the three nights, about 150 people came each night, and it was a really great time.
Yeah, I imagine it was pretty rewarding because you were helping some of the people there with your church or with your pastor, right?
It was with a local pastor from Ghana, and we were with my family.
Sounds like a plan. Now, down here, we have Ethan, who is very much the musician. What kind of music do you like to compose and work with?
I like to play a lot of jazz. I'm in a small jazz bands from time to time, and play a lot of folk music, modern, but yeah.
What kind of instruments do you play?
I play guitar, I sing, and a little bit of piano.
Okay, so watch for his CD someday. Now, we have Alec over here. You were on a trip to Jamaica recently. What did you do there?
I was on a missions team. I did medical, and my friend and I set up a soccer clinic for the kids there.
Now, how's your soccer team doing this year? You're going to be playing?
Yeah, we're playing today, actually, and we have to make it there on time.
Okay, and you're also into skeet shooting. You do that a little bit anyway, right?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah. Are you pretty good at it?
Decent.
He's decent. So that's a good step forward. He'll be shooting those skeets before you know it, but he won't be doing it today because we got to get back to the game. This is your team from Laconia Christian.
All right, Tim, thank you very much. There you look at the team from Laconia Christian. And right now, after round number one, holding on to a slim lead by a score of 50-40 over Stratford High School as we go to our second round. This is our bonus round. We'll ask the 10-point questions as we did in round one, but the team that gets the question correct then has a chance at additional bonus points. So good luck, Laconia Christian and Stratford. Here we go. First described in 1943 by psychiatrist Neil Kanner, treatment became a priority in 2001 under the Children's Health Act, as some 500,000, mostly male children, are known to have it. What is this ism, a neurological inability to communicate? Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Pass.
Stratford. Megan?
Autism.
Autism is right for the 10 points. So let's go over to Stratford. Megan, you are the team captain. You talk to everybody up there. You can choose from potpourri, grammatical goof-ups, or coming to terms with science. Potpourri, grammatical goof-ups, or coming to terms with science. Let's go with potpourri, and again, Megan, you can talk to everybody, but then I take your answer for the team. For 5 points each, identify each of the following. The U.S. president, whose disclosed medical files show him taking many medications a day for both his diagnosed Addison's disease and his back pain resulting from his PT-109 experience during World War II.
Truman?
It was Kennedy. Dance troupe that performs its trademark precision high kicks in the Radio City Christmas Spectacular in various U.S. cities by touring companies and in New York's Radio City Music Hall.
The Rockettes.
Correct. Jim Henson's puppet known for his song It's Not Easy Being Green.
Honored Kermit the Frog.
Kermit the Frog. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Well done. All right, let's go with a 10-point toss-up. Paper and pencil in front of you again if you think you may need it. We want you to write the value 74,020,000 in scientific notation. Write the value 74,020,000 in scientific notation. Matthew of Laconia Christian.
7.402 × 10⁷.
You got it. Absolutely right for the 10 points. So let's go over to Laconia Christian. Matthew, you're the team captain. You can talk to everybody. Choose from grammatical goof-ups, coming to terms with science, or lots of literature. Grammatical goof-ups, coming to terms with science, lots of literature.
We'll take lots of literature.
Lots of literature it will be for 5 points apiece. Answer each of the following questions concerning literature. The American author who focused on the naturalistic theme of survival of the fittest in such stories as To Build a Fire and The Law of Life.
Charles Darwin?
It was Jack London. The number of years that Jabez Stone agreed to when he sold his soul to the devil in Stephen Vincent Benet's short story, The Devil and Daniel Webster.
Seven.
Seven is correct. The American who wrote The Age of Innocence and Ethan Frome.
John Stewart.
Edith Wharton, but they get 5 out of 15 on their bonus, and we go with another 10-point toss-up. Which president in which location said, The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. Caleb of Stratford.
Abraham Lincoln at the Battle Grounds of Gettysburg.
You got it. Abraham Lincoln at Gettysburg is absolutely right. Well done. Back to Stratford we go. Well, you love grammatical goof-ups, so we'll offer that again. Coming to terms with science or Paraguay. Grammatical goof-ups, coming to terms with science or Paraguay.
Grammatical goof-ups, please.
Let's go with grammatical goof-ups. Identify each of the following concerning grammar. Grammatical error in the sentence, the candy was divided between the 10 of them.
Between? And it should be amongst?
That's it, among instead of a between. The grammatical error that should be avoided in the following sentence. I can't hardly hear you. The name for the grammatical error that should be avoided in that sentence.
The contraction can't?
It is what we were looking for, the double negative.
Oh.
And the name for the grammatical error in the sentence, walking to the park, a sudden rain drenched me. Anything, Megan?
No.
And we were looking for a dangling participle. All right, let's go with another 10 point. And no, we don't. There's the sound ending the round. We still have, with that, 5 points from the bonus on the board. Another close game with Stratford now holding on to the lead. 75 to 65. We're going to get into our 62nd round in just a moment. Right now, though, another timeout. This time, Tim Estilos joins us, talking with a team from Stratford High School.
Hey, Jim, this great-looking group of students is from Stratford Public School, and Megan is the team captain. Now, Megan, you are into sort of composing music and that kind of thing. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I like to compose pop music and rock music, and I play the piano and the guitar while I do it.
Mm-hmm. Now, are you also into drama and theater, that kind of thing?
Yes, I am, and I also wrote my own play that I'll be directing in March.
That's got to be exciting. You know, what is the play about?
It's about four teenagers when they start to grow up and separate, and then they get back together.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll look forward to that. Now we have Amelia over here who is into biochemistry. Why do you like that subject so much?
I ace both biology and chemistry, and it just comes naturally to me, and I really just want to do that as a career when I get older.
Mm-hmm. Now, of course, we're looking forward to some snow coming up soon. You're a big snowboarder, I understand.
Yeah, I taught myself when I was in eighth grade, and I got my Burton Feather snowboard a couple of years ago, so I'm excited to go snowboarding this winter.
Ah, so watch out for her on the slopes. Now, Caleb here. Caleb likes cows because his family has a dairy farm, right?
Yep. I show dairy cattle through 4-H, which I'm a big part of in the state of New Hampshire.
Mm-hmm. Now, what do you do with the cows? I mean, besides milking them, I mean, what goes into that? Because you also take them to the Big E recently. What was that involving?
Showing cattle, I had to get my animal ready and train her to walk, and then I brought her down for the 4-H show, and...
Did you win a ribbon?
I won a couple of ribbons.
No, he didn't win it. The cow won the ribbon. Please, don't take credit for your cow here. Now, Nicole over here, she's into hunting and fishing. So basically, yes, she kills Bambi, I know. But what do you like about hunting?
It's something no one else expects me to do. Mm-hmm. It just brings me out in the outdoors. I like being outdoors.
And you like to write stories as well. Tell me about that.
Yes.
What kind of stories do you like to write?
About non-fictional.
Non-fictional, things like that? And you do some fishing as well, right? What, you go fishing with your family, that kind of thing?
No, with my friends and boyfriend.
Ah, okay. So, and hopefully the boyfriend will not upset her because she knows how to pack a gun. Anyway, we're going to get back to the game. This is your team from Stratford High School.
All right, Tim, thank you. And that is the team from Stratford and holding on to a lead halfway through the game of 75 to 65 in a game that has been going back and forth. Let's find out what happens here in round number three. This is our 62nd round. We'll ask each team 10 questions in 1 minute. They get 10 points for every correct answer, a bonus of 10 points should they identify all the answers right in under a minute. So the team trailing gets to choose the categories first. So Laconia Christian, Matthew, you can talk to everybody between Olympic cities, author, or famous Williams. Olympic cities, author, or famous Williams.
We'll go with famous Williams.
All right, we'll go with famous Williams. Matthew, you can talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team. Give the surname of each of the following, all of whom have the first name William. Start the clock. William Butler Blank, Irish poet and dramatist who helped establish the Irish Literary Theater in 1898.
Awesome.
That was Yeats. William Childs Blank, commander of the U.S. forces in Vietnam from 64 to 68.
Johnson.
It was Westmoreland. William Lloyd Blank, abolitionist who published The Liberator.
Harrison.
It was Garrison. William Henry Blank, U.S. president, nicknamed Old Tip.
Harrison.
Correct. William Makepeace Blank, English author who created the character Becky Sharp.
Pass.
William Marcy Blank, known for his political corruption in New York City.
Johnson.
It was Tweed. William Barrett Blank, commander of the Texans at the Alamo. That's the round for the Nacho Fingers Williams, I guess, as they get 1 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So we'll put 10 points on the board for Laconia Christian. Go over to Stratford and offer them Olympic Cities or Author, Author.
Author, author.
Author, author it will be. Megan, you talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team. Identify the author of each of the following. Start the clock. Uncle Tom's Cabin.
Harriet Beecher Stowe.
Correct. Little House on the Prairie.
Laura Ingalls Wilder.
Correct. The Red Pony.
Pass.
Treasure Island.
Robert Louis Stevenson.
Correct. The Second Jungle Book.
Pass.
The Call of the Wild.
Pass.
Super Fudge.
Judy Blume.
Correct. The Yearling.
Pass.
The Last of the Mohegans.
Pass.
Winnie the Pooh.
Pass.
Hate yourself on that one. A.A. Milne. Judges. 4 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So 40 points onto the scoreboard for Stratford. We have completed round number 3, and Stratford continues to hold on to the lead by a score of 115 to 75. All right, teams, we're going into our fourth and final round. This is a 10-point toss-up round, which means no more talking to each other up there now. Here we go. Good luck, the winner, into our second round. Name the ancient Greek philosopher and student of Plato who rejected Democritus's theory of atomism. His theories dominated medieval philosophy. The Greek philosopher. Caleb of Stratford.
Aristotle.
Aristotle is correct. Identify the English publisher and bookseller who was the first to print and sell books for children, publishing Goody Two-Shoes in 1765, and for whom an annual award given to the best American children's book is named. Megan of Stratford.
Newbery.
Newbery is correct. Identify the radioactive isotope of carbon that contains 6 protons, 6 electrons. Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Carbon 14.
Carbon 14 is right. Name the foreign flag held by demonstrators gathered in Miami in 2000 to protest the U.S.'s decision. Ethan of Laconia Christian.
Cuban.
Cuba is correct. Which song, popularized by Tony Orlando, is based on a Civil War story about the homecoming of a Union soldier from a Confederate prison? Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Sweet Home Alabama.
Stratford. Caleb.
When Johnny Comes Marching Home Again.
It was Tie a Yellow Ribbon Around the Old Oak Tree. All right, we just have under 2 minutes to play, teams. Give the word ending in side, C-I-D-E, for the act of killing one's mother. Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Matricide.
Matricide is correct. A number of people in New York died in 1999 from the rare West Nile strain of encephalitis, a disease defined as an inflammation of which part of the body? Megan of Stratford.
The spinal cord.
Laconia Christian. Matthew.
The pancreas.
It is the brain. Identify the first dark horse candidate nominated on the 9th ballot who became the 11th U.S. president. Caleb of Stratford.
James Polk.
James Polk is right. We have 1 minute to go. Which animal depicted on a nickel first issued about 90 years earlier? Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Bison.
Judges, bison. I think we'll give it to them for 10 points. That is correct. Name two of the four U.S. presidents besides Ronald Reagan who were present at the 1991 dedication of the Reagan Library in Simi Valley, California. Caleb of Stratford.
Carter and George Bush Sr.
You got them, Ford and Nixon being the others. Homer's epic, The Iliad, tells about the last weeks of which war fought between Greece and Troy? Caleb of Stratford.
The Trojan War.
The Trojan War is right. What does lime remove from a field where plants are cultivated? Matthew of Laconia Christian.
Weeds.
Stratford. It is acidity, and that's the sound ending our game. What a well-played game tonight, but it'll be Stratford moving on into our second round with a victory of 165 to 115 tonight. Very well played, both teams. Congratulations to Stratford. Hope it was fun for Laconia Christian. Hope it'll be fun for you as well again 1 week from now as two new teams get ready to compete. They will be the teams from Bow High School and from Stevens High School. That's our game 1 week from tonight. Hope you enjoyed tonight's contest. See you in a week. Good night, everybody.